Hi everyone, my name is Kamil and I'm here to tell you how to play Micro Architects. So what you'll find in the box is the Architects board, the main hub for the game, containing the scoring track, different actions players can perform, a round summary, and a setup summary for each round. Also double layered city boards for each player. A player's city board consists of 32 lots divided into 8 blocks of two types, the green ones and the gray ones. The green ones are marked with a tree and the gray ones are marked with bricks. In each block there are 2 lots located by the mountains and 2 lots located by the water. A deck of goal cards. Each one is completely different. A deck of service cards. Landmark tiles, which are used for marking the requirements of your landmarks. An automa deck when playing solo. A whole bag of 120 wooden buildings. Of course, this is a prototype. These are still 3D printed plastic, and the bag is also plastic. As you can see, it will be a fabric bag in the final version of the game. Action tokens in the form of wrenches, 6 for each player, and lots of boat tokens, which you will get throughout the game, and they will let you acquire services. Each player also receives a resident board, but that will be used with the residence module. Also, together with 60 wooden meeples used for the residence module. I'll talk more about that in a different part of this video. Let's move on to the setup. Firstly, put the architect's board in the middle of the table. Each player places their scoring tokens beside the beside spot number 1 on the scoring track. A game of Micro Architects takes place over the course of 3 rounds. Prepare 2 goal tiles for each round of the game. So this will be round 1, round 2, and round 3. Rest of the goal tiles can be put aside as they won't be used for the rest of the game. Draw 3 service cards. Now, depending on the number of players, place a specific number of buildings below the architect's board. On the first round in a 2-player game, place 2 rows of 10 buildings. Plus an additional 6 buildings in the backup plans in the middle of the board. Place as many landmark tiles as there are landmarks, black buildings, in the top row and the backup plans. So in this case, 3. 1, 2, 3. Each player receives 2 action tokens and places them beside their board. Place the additional 4 action tokens for each player on the architect's board. Place the boat tokens within easy reach of each player. Okay, so how does a round of Micro Architects look like? As I mentioned, the game is played over 3 rounds with scoring at the end of each round. There are 3 types of scoring in the game. The first one are the goal tiles, which you can see from the beginning of the game, set up for each round. In this case, I know that at the end of round 1, I will score for these 2 goal tiles. So as you can see, even though I'm scoring only for 1 set of goal tiles, I can still see all the other goal tiles for the rest of the game, so I can simply plan ahead. The second type of scoring are services. Services score for pairs of buildings in their city. These 2 buildings don't have to be placed beside each other. You simply count the pairs of these buildings in the whole city. So in this scenario, I already have 2 points if I have this service in my city, as I have a green and a red building. The third type of scoring are landmarks. Whenever you pick a black building, you take a landmark tile to go with it, and you place it beside the block where the landmark is located. I'll talk more about that scoring in a second. On a player's turn, all you have to do is take one building from the top row and place it in your city. The first thing you have to consider is probably to match the gold tiles. So I'll start off by taking a green building and I'll simply place it here. Maybe I'll go for this goal and try to surround a blue building, as I can see that there are lots of green buildings. As I mentioned, if a building that I pick is a landmark, which is this black building, I always take a landmark tile to go with it. As an example, I'll take this landmark on my next turn and I'll try to place it here in this block, and each landmark tile has specific requirements. The bottom one tells you which type of block it would like to be located in this case the tree, which I mentioned are the green blocks, by the mountains. So this spot is actually perfect for the landmark. This already gives me 1 point at the end of the round. The other thing that's important on the landmark tiles are the types of buildings it wants to be surrounded by. In this case, the purple ones and green ones. I already have a green building surrounding it, which means that I already have 1 point at the end of the round. You can always score a maximum of 4 points for each landmark. Let me give you an example of this. Right now, this landmark is located in the right spot in the green block by the mountains, and it's surrounded by 2 purple buildings and a green building, each of them giving me 1 point at the end of the round, for a total of 4 points. Now, whenever I fill a whole block, I always gain a boat token and place it beside that block. Whenever I have 2 boats in my city, I can slide them over to mark that they were used, and for these 2 boat tokens, I can gain a service tile of my choice from the 3 ones that are on display. So in my case, I would probably take one of these 2, as both of them score for pairs with green buildings. I already have 1 green building, so I'll probably just put it beside my city board. And now I'll know that I have to gain more red buildings and green buildings to score more points for that service card. Players take turns one after the other until the current row is empty. When the current row is empty, fill up the landmark tiles so that they match again with the number of landmark buildings in the current row and the backup plans, which in this case are 2. And the next player to the left starts this row of buildings. Okay, so when the final row is empty, we move on to the scoring phase and the cleanup phase after that. These phases are depicted here with these illustrations. First of all, the star symbol means scoring. So we get score points for the gold tiles for this round. In this example, well, the red player hasn't scored any points, but the blue player scored 6 points, 5 points for this gold tile in this block. We get points for services. The red player wasn't able to get 2 boats, which means he wasn't able to get a service tile, service card. The blue player got a service card, giving them 2 points for each pair of yellow and green buildings. In this case, 2 pairs, so 4 points. And the last thing are the landmarks. Both players have landmarks in their cities. The red player scores 4 points for this landmark tile, as it's in the right spot surrounded by three buildings of the desired types. The blue player gains 4 points for this landmark. And 2 points for this landmark, because it's placed correctly and there's one building of the desired type beside it. After that, we cover up the gold tiles for this round, as they won't be used anymore. We switch the buildings from the backup plans for 6 new ones. We place new buildings under the architect's board according to the current round. So in this case, round number 2 for 2 players will be 2 rows of 8 buildings. We get rid of all landmark tiles from the previous round. And again, we place as many landmark tiles as there are in the backups and the current row, which means 3 landmark tiles. And each player receives 2 additional action tokens. Which leads me to the next segment, which are the actions players can perform on their turns. Apart from taking a building on their turn, players may use up to 2 action tokens to perform extra actions. These actions are depicted here on the right side of the architect's board. The first action means that you might swap 2 buildings with each other on the on your city board. Action number 2 means you might move a building to an empty spot. Action number 3 means you can swap a building from your city with the backup plans. Again, if you are taking a landmark building from the backups, you also take a landmark tile as you would normally. The 4th action only works with the residence module. I'll talk about that later. And the last action means that whenever you're taking a service tile, you can spend an action token to draw 2 additional service cards. And that way you will pick from 5 instead of 3, which simply gives you more options. Players may also use one of their unused boats, to retrieve 2 action tokens from the ones they used already. After round 3, score points the same way as after every other round. So for goals, services, and landmarks. Also, additionally, each unused boat token is worth 2 victory points. And each unused action token is worth 1 victory point. The player with the most points is considered the winner and the chief architect of the city. The game comes with a separate residence module. The resident module consists of a resident board for each player, as well as lots of resident meeples that will be placed along with the buildings. So how to play the residence module? You set up the game as you would normally. After the normal setup, place resident tokens next to every other building, starting from the first one on the left. So in this case, I would place a purple resident by this building, a black resident by the landmark, another purple one here, and a green resident by the green building. You play the game as you would normally, with one change. Whenever you take a building, take also the resident that comes with it. You place the building normally, and you place the resident on your resident board, starting with the first spot from the left. Each row on the resident board can only have residents of one type. Black resident token, the one that comes with the landmark, can count as any color. But you have to remember that if you start a row with the landmark resident, you have to continue with landmark residents till the end. Whenever you fill the last spot of a row, you gain one of two bonuses. You either retrieve one action token or you gain three victory points. Also, whenever you fully complete two adjacent rows, you gain an additional boat token, which can be used as a normal boat token throughout the game, which again gives you more opportunities to score points for services. The resident module also comes with an additional action you might perform, the one visible here, which means that you can spend an action token, and when taking a resident that comes with the building, you might swap it from a resident of your choice from the pool of residents and place it on your resident board. That's it. That's the module is super easy to implement, but gives you a nice way of gaining more points, gives you more possibilities as you are retrieving action tokens, which again might give you more scoring opportunities for goals, and of course boats, which will allow you to score more points for services. Okay, thank you for listening. I hope I presented the game in a clear way. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave a comment or send us a message. Thank you.